Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to go very basic step by step from scratch, and we are going to learn all about TestProject's APIs. So we are going to see what is TestProject APIs and how to use these APIs. We will look at some examples, and we are also going to learn how you can use the TestProject APIs from external tool or external processes. So let's get started, and let us first start with TestProject API introduction. So in TestProject, there is a set of APIs or RESTful APIs that you can use to do all the operations that you can do on TestProject from any external environment. So for that, let me go to my TestProject. I have already logged in, and now I will go to the integrations here. And here we have this section for API. I'll go here, and here you can see we have a API documentation. I will click on the API documentation, and this takes me to a new page for TestProject's API. And here you can see these are all the APIs, and all these are available for free. And it says TestProject exposes a RESTful API which allows R&D teams to schedule and trigger automation, get status and retrieve testing results. So all these options, all these operations you can do using these APIs. And these APIs will be very useful when you are creating your CI/CD pipelines, or whenever you want to call any TestProject operations from any external tool or any external environment like your own framework or maybe a CI tool like Jenkins. And here you can see a list of all the APIs, and they are very neatly categorized in sections. So here you can see all the APIs related to agents. Here you can use APIs to get a particular agent, get the agent status, etc. And you can also go and click on any of the APIs, and you can see all the details, all the description parameters, and the different responses, codes and descriptions. And here is a tryout button. If you click on tryout, you can provide your details here and then click on execute, and it will show you a response. I will show you this in a moment. So these are agent APIs. Then if I scroll down, we have all the application related APIs here. We have data sources API, jobs API. If you want to create a job, update a job, delete job, or even execute a job, all this can be done through APIs here. And then we have project parameters and project related APIs, reports related APIs. So you can also get reports using APIs and test packages. So these are different types of APIs. Now let us see how to use these APIs and also see some good examples of these APIs. So to use these APIs, I will go back to my API section here, and first I need to create a API key. So I will click on create API key. You can give any name here. I will say, let me just say API demo test, and click on next. And here I can provide the permissions. So if I want to provide permission to some particular project, I can select it like this from here. Or if I want to have all the permissions, I will say unrestricted. So this will have access to all the projects, and I will say finish here. And now I have got this API. I can copy this from here and then go to the API documentation page here, and we have a authorization option here. I will click this and paste the value of the key and click on authorize. And now it says I am authorized. So you can see here. And also, in case you want to use this API from any external tool or any external process, you will have to provide a header called authorization and the value of this key. And I will show you this in a moment. For now, I am authorized here, so I can close this. And now I can use any of these APIs. So let's just say I use this first API, which returns the account agents. So all my agents I can see from the response of this API. I will click try it out, and here you can see all these are non-optional fields, and here is the maximum count I need. So I will just click on execute, and here if I go down, you can see in the response I'm getting status code 200. And in the response body, I'm getting all the agents from my account. So you can see all these agents are here. This is a Windows agent which has this name, Then this is another agent. All these agents are here, and I can also show you from my account. If I go to agents, all these agents are here and all these are listed in the response here. So this is how you can use it. Then we have all these APIs related to agents, then applications, data sources, jobs, and then we have project parameters and reports. Let me try a reports API. So here, let me say I want to get a report for some particular job, the latest report. So I will click here, and here if I click on try it out, I need a project ID and then I need the job ID. So for that, I will go to my test project home and I will get this project. So here I will click on these three dots and copy the ID. This will be the project ID and I will paste it here. And then for the job ID, I will go inside the project. And here are all my jobs. I can again go to any job, click on these three dots and copy the ID. And then I will paste the job ID here. Now here are some more non-mandatory parameters. So for now, let me just try to execute and check. I will click on execute. And you can see in the response, I'm getting the response body here, and this is the report URL. So you can see in the response, I'm getting all the details, the ID, the result type is passed, the agent used, the execution start and the execution end time, and then the URL of the report. So I can copy this URL and just check here. This should show me the report of that particular job, the latest report. So here you can also see all the response headers and all the details here. And here, let me check very quickly if it shows me the report. And yes, the report is coming up and it shows me the latest report for that particular job. And all these details are here. And then you will also see that here it also gives us a curl command or a curl command. And it also gives us a request URL. So this we can use from any external tool as well. So let me try to show you. If I try to use this same thing, I will just copy this request URL and I will go to Postman, or you can use any other API tool, and I will create a new request and I will just copy the URL that I have copied from test project. And this is a GET request. So you can see this is a GET request. So I'm using a GET request here. And this is the URL. Now, if I just, you can see in the parameters, it has already taken the details, the format. And now, if I just run it now, I will see the response. And in the response, I'm getting 401, that is unauthorized. So I have not yet provided the authorization, and for that I will need to provide the authorization. That is, I have to give the header as authorization and the value of that particular API key. So I will copy this and go to the headers and use the key as authorization and the value as the API key value. So for that I will again go to my integrations and go to API, and here I will copy the API key and provide the value here, and then I will again click on send. And you can see this time I'm getting the status as 200, okay, and I'm also getting the response, that is I'm getting the report details, I'm getting the ID, the result, the agent used, execution start time, end time, and the URL of the report. So the same things that we were getting in test project API documentation. So this is how you can also use any of these APIs from any external tools. And this will be very handy whenever you have to do any kind of integration with test project, or you want to do any operation on test project from any external tool, any external environment, or during CI/CD pipeline. you can use TestProject API as, and everything is free here. So we have also seen how we can call TestProject APIs from external tools like Postman. And with that, I hope all this was very useful and now you are completely equipped to use TestProject APIs. You can try some more examples, and if you have any questions or any doubts, you can let me know and I will try to reply to you as soon as I can. And I will meet you in the next session of TestProject. Thank you for watching.